Hello everyone and welcome to the show. So Barcelona is going to be visiting Anoeta to play against Real Sociedad. And it's going to be very tough going to that stadium because Real Sociedad always finds a way to give a tough fight against Barcelona. And if we look at the recent history between these two teams, before Valverde, over the past 10 games, we only managed to get 5 wins. With Valverde, we have 4 wins out of 4 games. Tomorrow could be our 5th. So surprisingly, we are in better form going against Real Sociedad under Valverde. And so I want to focus a little bit on Real Sociedad. So Real Sociedad hasn't been getting the most wins in the past few matches, but in the table in the league, you can see that they're still 4th place and they're pretty close to catching FC Barcelona. If they beat Barcelona, they're only going to be 4 points behind them. So I guess we can say that they're on form and their main point of attack is Odegaard and Willian Jose. Willian Jose has 7 goals and Odegaard has 3. Going on to assist, Odegaard has a total of 4 assists. They have been involved in 14 games out of 16 so far this season. And I want to point something out. I want to talk about their attack for a little bit. In their last game against Eibar, Real Sociedad loves to sneak their wing or left back on the other side of the play. And we can see here in the pictures that when they were attacking, they had Eibar's focus all on the right side. Meanwhile, on the left side, on the other side of the pitch, Real Sociedad was having a left winger or a fullback run up and sneak up into that attack. And so just look at how Eibar was so focused on that right side of the attack, leaving the number 10 unmarked. And then we can see here again, Real Sociedad did the exact same play and they had another player unmarked on the left side of the attack. And so that's something that Real Sociedad loves to do. And the reason why I pointed this out is because Barcelona always does this mistake, this defensive mistake. If we look at their last game against Mallorca, I pointed this out last video. We can see that the Mallorca forward was going to center the ball into the box. And so he did, right? And we can see all the way on the left side, the Mallorca winger was unmarked. And so since he was unmarked, Sergio Roberto had no choice but to mark 2 players in the same time. So he didn't know what to do. And so because Sergio Roberto had to mark 2 players, it led to the goal. And I pointed this out last video. Barcelona needs to be aware of their surroundings. They need to know who's behind them and who's in front of them. We can't just focus on one side of the pitch. And so Barcelona consistently does this mistake. We can see here in the game against Leganés. We did win in this game, but it wasn't the most convincing win. We can see that Leganés was attacking on the right side, leaving number 7, the winger, all the way on the left side open. And we can see as we go through these pictures, number 7 continues to run and he was asking for the ball because he was wide open. And we can see that all the Barcelona players were focusing on the right side. They had all their attention on that right side, and again leaving number 7 open on the other side, which is a huge defensive mistake. You have to be aware of your surroundings. And so this is something that Barca needs to be aware of. And Real Sociedad is a great team and they are much better than Leganés. So if Barcelona does this mistake against the wrong team, we could see a few goals going in our own net. So now I want to speak about Barcelona. In our last La Liga game, we did win 5-2 against Mallorca. And in our most recent game, we did win 2-1 against Inter Milan in the Champions League, which send us to the next round of the UCL. So right now we're picking up a very good momentum and that's going to help us as we go into this game on Saturday. This will also be Griezmann's reunion with Real Sociedad. He did start his career with them before he went to Atletico Madrid back in 2014. So it's going to be very interesting to see how Griezmann is treated at that stadium and how he plays against his old team. And so now Barcelona did announce their squad list, their 19-man squad list, and I'm very glad to see Todibo in it, Ansu Fati, Paris, and Alenia, who all stood out in the game against Inter Milan. But most importantly, we do have Semedo and Jordi Alba back, and it has been over a month that they have been absent. Messi and Piquet are also back after being rested, but Arthur has also been left out of the squad for like the 4th time to 5th time this season. And I know many of you are asking, oh, what happened to Arthur? Valverde doesn't like to use Arthur no more. And sources have claimed, I don't know if this is true, this may not be true, but sources have claimed that Arthur does have gonorrhea, which is like a STD infection. And if it is true, it is best to keep that behind closed doors, because I wouldn't want Barca or Arthur to announce to the world saying, oh, I have an STD infection, I have gonorrhea. That wouldn't be right. It's best to keep your mouth shut and just move on forward. And this is why Arthur sits out of the games with no explanation. So this could be true, but then again, it's not official. But eventually we're gonna have to get answers. And so Valverde did speak earlier for the pre-match press conference, and he said, over the years, it has been one of the most difficult places to visit. The last 2 seasons, we have won, but it was on the back of a bad streak. If we add to this how La Real are doing, playing good football with great players and using the last clash here at the Camp Nou as a reference will be a tough game. They are a team that clearly have a plan, always trying to win the ball back. Mikel Merino and Martin Odegaard connect quickly with the attack and have a lot of spark. Then the reporters asked Valverde about the Classico, and this is what he said. "We will see what we're going to do from Sunday. We are not thinking behind Saturday's game. I don't want us to lose concentration over tomorrow." And so that's good that we have that type of focus. We can't be thinking about the Classico right now because we have to win against Real Sociedad, because if we lose, we're going to fall behind. So it's good that we just focus one game at a time. And so Odegaard also spoke out, but it wasn't a pre-match press conference. And he said, "They are playing really well now, but I think we can beat the best teams around. Against Madrid and Atletico, we played well. It'll be special. We want to play well and cause them problems." So now I want to speak about the predicted score, the lineup, and what I want to see in this game. So I'm going to start with the predicted lineup, and I'm going to have Ter Stegen in goal, Sergio Roberto on the right side, Piqué and Umtiti as center backs, and Jordi Alba on the left side. I know that we have Semedo available now, but the thing is we should wait and have Semedo just come in like in the 60th minute, or I don't know, because I don't want him to start coming off an injury, especially since we have another right back available. I would like to have Sergio Roberto on that right side. And the only reason why I say put Alba on the left side is because we don't have another left back in the squad list. Junior Firpo was left out from the squad. And so yeah, I want to see Jordi Alba on that left side. In the middle, I have Vidal, Busquets, and De Jong. And up top, I would like to have Messi on the right, Suarez in the middle, and Griezmann on the left. The subs that I would like to see is Alenia coming in for either De Jong or Vidal, Ansu Fati coming in for Griezmann, and Semedo coming in for Sergio Roberto. But look, whatever Valverde wants to do in tomorrow's match, the one thing I want to see is the academy players being used in this game. Regardless if you think that it might be a risk, I do believe in our academy players, and it has been shown in the game against Inter Milan that the academy players are ready. They don't have to start in the starting 11, but they should be given more minutes, especially Ansu Fati, Alenia, and Todibo. They proved on Wednesday that they are ready and that they should be playing more minutes. Valverde has to see that there is a big opportunity that these players can grow. And so my predicted score is going to be 3-1. And the reason why I say 3-1 is because Barcelona is not going to keep a clean sheet like I say every game. We have been doing that defensive mistake for a very long time now, and I don't think it's going to be fixed overnight. So Real Sociedad will score a goal against Barcelona. But now having Messi rested and Suarez in good form and Griezmann connecting with Messi better, I do believe that we're going to score 3 goals at the Anoeta, and it's going to be very exciting to see. And so remember, we cannot lose any games. If we do lose any games before El Clasico, we will be behind Real Madrid. And so it's going to be a very exciting game tomorrow. I hope we do get this win. If you're watching this video, please support Barcelona. We need you guys. We need to be together. We are in a big winning streak right now. We haven't lost since like that 3-1 game against Levante. The front three are starting to click. We have the academy players starting to shine. So there is a lot to look up to right now. Let's continue to support and do our part and just hope for the best. And so thank you guys for watching. I appreciate it. Thank you for showing all the love. I'm going to be covering tomorrow's match after the game, which is the post-match review. So yeah, thank you, and I'll see you guys tomorrow.